So we are now looking at what is beam. So to look at what do we mean by beam? Beam. Let me start by classifying the structures or structural parts that we see around into three categories. So there are certain members, for example, tube light. Then spoon. Railing of a chair. This is one class of members. Then another class of members is notebook. Tabletop. Wall, mobile screen, sorry, laptop screen. Om, can you tell me what is exactly the difference between these two class of members? Is there a difference?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what is the difference?
Like the breadth of this upper one, upper group is less than that of lower one. Like lower ones are type of sheet.
Yes. So if you look at all the members that are listed in class one, that is tube light, spoon, and railing of a chair, they have their one dimension dominant over the other two orthogonal directions. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore we call these members as 1D members or skeletal members. Are you with me? Why do we
Yes.
call them as skeletal? Because if you look at your own skeletal, most of the bones do have their one dimension dominant over the other two dimensions. Therefore, we call these members as 1D or skeletal members. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, let us go to the second class of members. So, if you look at notebook, tabletop, wall, laptop, screen, all of these, they have their two dimensions comparable with each other, whereas the third dimension is very small in comparison with the other two orthogonal directions. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
So, therefore, we call these members as either 2D members or planar members. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, there is slight change the way in which we are going to conduct the classes now. If anyone has any doubt in between, possibly you will not be able to unmute yourself, but you have to write down it in chat box. So reading the chat box, I will unmute that person to ask the doubt. So that's how we are going to proceed. You can stop me wherever you want if you have a doubt. Now, so tube light, spoon, railing of chair, these are 1D or skeletal members. Notebook, tabletop, wall, or laptop screen, these are 2D or planar members. So what is beam? So beam, out of these two classes, beam lies in the first class. Are you with me? So therefore,
yes.
What is beam? Beam is a 1D member. That means its length is going to be dominant over its breadth and thickness. Are you with me? Breadth and depth.
Yes.
Is it 1D member? Now, if you look at column, you will be tentatively knowing what is a column. If you look at the column, even column has its one dimension dominant over the other two dimensions. So it is also a skeletal member. So merely because the member is 1D, we cannot call that member as beam. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So before giving the further further characterization of beam, now let us define what do we mean by axis of a skeletal member. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
The batch which has practical with me, that is N1 batch. I think Om, you are from N1 batch itself, right?
Yes, sir.
So we have discussed discussed this in practical already, but for others, I am going to discuss it once more. So, axis of a skeletal member. That's what we will define first. Skeletal or 1D member. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Om, as you are from my batch, let me ask someone else to unmute, because then I will be very sure if they have understood or not. So, you can mute yourself.
Okay.
I will ask now. यशराज कैन यू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ? यशराज शिंदे यशराज कैन यू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ? देर इज ए माइक प्रॉब्लम दैट्स व्हाट ही सेज ओके सो देन लेट अस गो टू ओंकार सोनावणे कैन यू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ? ओंकार सोनावणे प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ। Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So please keep yourself unmuted for some time. Now we will discuss something called as axis of a skeletal member. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. No, again I am listening to my own voice. So you can mute yourself. चल मधुरा यू अनम्यूट युअर सेल्फ। मधुरा पाटील यस सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नाउ एक्सिस ऑफ स्केलेटल मेंबर। सो स्केलेटल और वन डी मेंबर इज अ मेंबर व्हिच हैज इट्स वन डायमेंशन डोमिनेंट ओवर द अदर टू डायमेंशन। सो लेंथ इज डोमिनेंट ओवर इट्स विड्थ एंड थिकनेस। दैट्स व्हाट दैट्स हाउ वी डिफाइन a 1D or skeletal member. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I give you a point of this beam, how many axes do pass through this point?
Infinite.
Infinite. So, out of which, out of those infinite axes, by definition, we define the axis of skeletal member in the following way. So, what do we do is, we take a section. We take a section perpendicular to the length of the member. So greatest dimension is length. So we take a section perpendicular to the length. So if I cut the skeletal member in this fashion, what do I see? So in this case, I am going to see the rectangle. And then we locate the centroid of this rectangle. You already know how to locate the centroid. Now, if I go on taking this section across the length, which is called as cross section, from point to point, and for each cross section, if I go on joining this centroid point, I get something called as axis of a skeletal member. I hope I am very clear. So, axis of a skeletal member is longitudinal centroidal axis. It is along the length of the member. So, we have defined two things. What is a skeletal member? Skeletal member is the member in which one dimension is dominant over the other two dimensions. And what is axis of skeletal member? Axis of skeletal member is the longitudinal centroidal axis. So it is going to be parallel to the length of skeletal member. Now what is beam? So let us now try to once again go back to the definition of beam. So as long as you have the loading that is perpendicular to this axis of a skeletal member, I am going to classify that element as a beam. So what is the next condition? Loading should be perpendicular to the axis. So loading should be perpendicular to the length. So for example, if I consider this member, just merely because it is vertical, I am not going to call it as column. I have to check what is the load on it. Let us say the load is in this direction. That means this is the axis of the member column and the load is perpendicular to the axis. And therefore, this member has to be categorized as B. I hope you are understanding what I'm trying to say. Now imagine there is a horizontal 1D member. So one dimensional horizontal member and it is subjected to loading along the axis. This is loaded along the axis. I am not going to call this as beam. This is not a beam. This is beam. This is not a beam. Why? Because the loading is along the axis. Only and only when the loading is perpendicular to the axis of a member, then only I call that member as beam. So there are two conditions for a particular member to be called as beam. One, it has to be a skeletal or one dimensional member. and the loading has to be perpendicular to the longitudinal axis. If these two conditions are satisfied, then we call the member as beam. Now let us look at, based on this and the concepts of equilibrium that we have learned, now let us solve few of the problems. So this is problem number 38, where for a beam and the loading as shown, determine reaction at A. You have to determine the reaction at A and tension in cable BC. So you have to understand that this BC is a cable. Now you can imagine, if I have cable and if I try to compress it, it is not going to resist, it is going to give way. You can hold a thread in your hand and try to compress it, try to bring two ends together, and it is going to, there will not be absolutely any resistance. So therefore cables cannot produce compressive resistance. That's what you have to understand. Compression cannot be produced in the cable. So cables can only have tensile forces. You try to take both the ends of the thread in your hand away, and the cable is going to resist. The thread is going to resist because it has tensile tension carrying capacity, but it doesn't have the compression carrying capacity. Just give me a minute. So cables can produce only tensile reactions and no compressive reactions. Now, look at this member now. Is it a 1D member? Yes. Its cross-section is not shown, but the way in which it is drawn, that means that its cross-sectional dimensions or dimensions in the plane perpendicular to the plane of board are going to be small in comparison with this total length. So total length is 6 plus 8 plus 8 plus 6. So 6, 6, 12, 12 plus 8, 28, 28 plus 8. That is 36. So 36 inches is the length of this member, and in comparison to that, breadth and depth are going to be small. That's why they are not shown, or that they are not explicitly mentioned in the problem. So therefore, by definition, this is a 1D or skeletal member, and mind you, it is loaded perpendicular to its axis. Why? Because its axis is longitudinal centroidal axis, so it is going to be something like this. So this is the member loaded perpendicular to its axis by point loads, and therefore we are going to classify this as beam. So first observation, that this member is beam as given in the problem. Now we need to find out two things. We need to find out reaction at A and tension in cable B. I hope you are with me. Now I want Muskan, please unmute yourself. Muskan Patel, please unmute yourself. Muskan, can you unmute yourself? Okay, Atharva, please unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
So now this is the beam, and these are the various loads that are acting on the beam. Now we need to find out reaction at A and tension in cable BC. So we have to draw free body diagram. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So free the body from all external agencies and show what the external agencies must have been doing. This is called as free body diagram. So I must draw free body diagram of what? Should I draw the free body diagram of string, or should I draw the free body diagram of beam?
Sir, beam.
Yes, because we don't have to only decide tension in the string, we have to also decide the reaction at A. Therefore, free body diagram of beam must be drawn. So free body diagram of beam, that means free the body from all external agencies. So let me free this beam from all external agencies. The first external agency is earth. So if I free the body from earth, what should I show? I should show the self weight of the beam. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But is any information on self weight of the beam is given in the problem?
No.
No. So therefore, it is the other way of telling that you have to neglect the self weight, or self weight is negligible in comparison with all other forces that have been shown. Are you with me? Okay. So free the body from earth, and we would have ideally shown its self weight, but that self weight is negligible is what indirectly told in the problem. So therefore, forget about it. Now, what else is external? Is support A external to the beam? Atharva, why not? Support is external to the beam. Beam is supported on some arrangement at A. So therefore, that supporting arrangement has to be external. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
From where do you derive your support right now? If you are sitting on a chair, you derive your support from chair. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Is chair external to you? Yes, obviously. Therefore, the supporting arrangement has to be treated as an external entity to the beam. So I treat now this beam as this support at A as an external agency. So I have to free the beam from support. So I have freed the beam from support. Now, what kind of support is it? Can you tell me, Atharva? Is it roller support, hinge support, or fixed support? No. Bhul gaye kya? We have seen that this and this representation is for a hinge support. Are you with me? So this is hinge support. Are you with me? Ye jo support dikh raha hai, wo kaun sa support hai? Hinge support. Now tell me, how many reactions can a hinge support offer? Yes, and both are force reactions. I hope you agree with me.
Yes.
So this is x direction. This is y direction. Coming out of the plane of boat towards you is z direction. So at A, we are going to have two reactions. One vertical reaction. So I am going to call this as VA, vertical reaction at A. And at the same time, I am also going to have horizontal reaction at A. And right now I assume it to be towards left. I could have assumed both these reactions in contrary sense as well. That's okay. At the end of analysis, if you get negative sign, that means the originally assumed senses of the reactions are incorrect. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So I assume that at point A, this beam has two reactions, HA and VA. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, just a minute. Fine. Now, what else is external to this beam? What else is external? Is this string external to the beam?
Yes,
because we are drawing free body diagram of beam. Therefore, I have to free the beam from string as well. So if I free the beam from string, then what should I show here? The string can only carry tension. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So if I release the string, that means string must be pulling point B. Usme agar tension hai, to it must be pulling point B. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
String cannot push a point because the string cannot offer compressive reaction. Happy? So therefore, I am going to call this reaction. And tell me, can there be any horizontal component of this reaction? Not possible. String is vertical. Therefore, it is going to apply only vertical pull. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, this reaction is the total reaction at B. So I am going to call it as RB. So at B, we have two components of reaction, VA and HA. Whereas at B, we have only one component of reaction, and that too, it is going to be away from B because the string is going to pull point B. It cannot push the point B. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And now these forces which are shown on this body, on this beam, they must be applied by some external agencies. So I need to show those forces as well. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let me show those forces. So this is 15 pound force. Now I will not mention the unit. It is already mentioned here. 15 pound force. Then you have 20 compound force, then you have, then you have 35 pound force, and then you have 20 pound force. Are you with me? And then here you have 15 pound force. So I will write those numbers: 15, 20, 35, 20, and 15. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, is this free body diagram complete? Atharva. Is it complete? Give some answer. Yes, no, or you are not sure.
Not sure.
So what is free body diagram? Free the body from all external agencies and show what all external agencies were doing. So we have shown what all external agencies are doing, except for one thing, that we have not shown the locations. So therefore, you also have to mention the locations with reference to a particular point. So you have to also write down these distances: 6 inch, then this is 8 inch. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This is 8 and this is 6. This completes the free body diagram. Are you with me? I have nowhere mentioned the units. Ideally, I should write units as well, but we understand that the length is measured in inches and force is measured in pound force. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, how many unknowns are there? Tell me. In the free body diagram, how many unknowns are there?
Two.
What are these two unknowns? Tell me.
B.
RB. That's what you are trying to say. Okay. So RB is one unknown. What else? Or koi unknown hai kya ispe? Are, do you know the value of VA?
No, no.
Yes, do you know the value of HA?
Yes.
How?
No, we are not knowing.
So therefore there are total three unknowns. Kon kon se hai? HA, VA, and RB. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Acha. Now quickly tell me, what kind of force system is this? Kon se tarike ka force system hai? Are lines of actions of all forces lying in single plane? Are they lying in single plane?
Yes.
Yes. So is it a coplanar force system?
Yes.
Yes. So it is coplanar force system. Now, are lines of actions of all the forces meeting in one point?
Yes.
Where? If I draw a line of action of this force, it goes like this. Line of action of this force goes like this. Where do they meet? Do they meet?
No.
So lines of actions of all the forces are not meeting at a point. So it is non-concurrent force system. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So coplanar but non-concurrent. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So for coplanar and non-concurrent force system, how many equations of equilibrium do make sense? Dekho, force ke equilibrium equation kon kon se hai, batao mujhe. Summation fx equal to 0, do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Summation, dusra equation kon sa hai, bolo. Summation fy equal to 0. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
This is x, this is y. And coming out of the plane of board towards you is z. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, if I take summation fz equal to 0, is there any force in z direction?
No.
No. So 0 equal to 0 is the trivial identity. Though that equation is satisfied, it is useless because it does not involve any unknown. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So only meaningful force equations are two: summation fx equal to 0 and summation fy equal to 0. Now tell me, how many moment equilibrium equations do we have? Summation of moments of all the forces about x-axis passing through a point under consideration is 0. Summation of moment of all the forces about y-axis passing through a point under consideration is 0. and summation of moments of all the forces about z axis passing through a point under consideration is zero. These are the three equilibrium equations, moment equilibrium equations. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Now these forces, as they lie in xy plane, they cannot produce moment about x or y axis. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, these two equations, though satisfied, they are meaningless. They are useless equations. They do not involve unknowns. Are you with me? So the only equation that we should be concerned about is this third equation. So total, how many equations are there? Tell me. Two force equations and one moment equation. So we have total three equilibrium equations and we have total three unknowns. Are you with me? So can we solve for the unknowns now? Yes, easily. So these are unknowns. And these are equations, three equations, three unknowns. We can straight away solve for them. So let us write down first equation, summation fx equal to zero. So summation fx equal to zero gives me what? Tell me. Is there any force in free body diagram which is shown in x direction? Atharva, how? HA ka direction kya hai? So HA is the only force that is in x direction in the free body diagram. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And it is in negative x direction. So I am going to call it as minus HA. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
There is no other force. So summation fx is only minus HA. This has to be equal to zero. That means HA has to be equal to zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So HA. So we have got one reaction at A and that is zero. Happy?
Yes.
Now, which is the second equation that I should use? Tell me. Summation Fy? Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
If I use summation Fy equal to zero, you are going to have all these forces. You are also going to have Va and you are also going to have Rb. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But then there are two unknowns in a single equation. I cannot solve straight away for any of the unknowns. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So it is better now to use summation of moment equation first. So zara dekho, if I take moment of all the forces about A, moments of VA and HA are going to vanish. Why? Because their lines of actions pass through A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So only unknown that produces moment about A will be Rb, and I will straight away get the value of Rb. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, the next equation that I am going to use is summation of moment of all the forces about z axis. Are you with me? Through A, z axis passing through A. This is equal to zero. Happy?
Yes.
चलो तो किसका किसका मोमेंट आएगा नाउ दिस 15 व्हाट विल बी द मोमेंट टेल मी अबाउट ए कितना आएगा इसका मोमेंट
90
नो नो डोंट टेल मी डायरेक्टली द वैल्यू यू शुड टेल मी द इक्वेशन 15 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय व्हाट Are you there, Atharva? Okay. Mokshat, can you unmute yourself? Mokshat, can you unmute yourself? Yes. You tell me what is the moment of 15 about A?
Distance 8 plus 22.
Correct. So total distance is 6 plus 8 plus 8, 16 plus 6, 22, and that multiplied by 15. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the sign? Tell me. What kind of moment does it produce, clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
So therefore it is positive.
Positive.
Agreed? Chalo. Yes, now next, what is the moment of 20? Tell me.
About A, it will be 20 into 16.
Correct. Right now we are taking moment only about A itself. So 20 into 16. And what will be the sign? Is it anti-clockwise? Yes, it is positive. So 15 into 22 plus 20 into 16. Now what is the moment of 35 about A?
35 into 8.
35 into 8, and that is also positive. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
We have done this so many times, so we are now just quickly writing this down. We are using the equations of equilibrium in the context of beam. Are you with me? So 35 into 8. Now, what is the moment of this 20 about A?
Zero.
Zero, because its line of action passes through A. What is the moment of VA and HA about A? Zero?
Yes.
Yes. Now, what is the moment of this 15 about A?
15 into 6, minus sign.
Yes. Why? Because it is going to be clockwise. So therefore, minus 15 into 6. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And what is the moment of this RB about A?
RB, sir, say RB into 6.
And what is the sign?
Negative.
Yes, because it is clockwise. So with the sense that we are assumed for RB, the sign is negative. RB multiplied by 6. Because we are assumed RB to be downwards, it is producing clockwise moment about A. Therefore, it is negative. Are you with me? It is not the sign of RB as such. It is the sign of moment produced by RB about A. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And this has to be equal to 0. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And now solve for RB then and tell me what is the value of RB. So RB into 6 comes to right hand side. So you have to just calculate 15 into 22 plus 20 into 16 plus 35 into 8 minus 15 into 6. This whole divided by 6. Tell me how much is that? How much? Mokshad?
Yes, yes, sir. One forty.
Yes. Even Kushagra also has said 140. So we have independent matching. Great. And it is in pounds, LB. Now it is plus. So what is the meaning of this plus sign? Tell me.
Our assumption is right.
So it is not that RB is upward. No. This plus sign means that originally say assumed sense of RB is correct. And therefore it is downward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
देखो थोड़ा सा आयरोनिकल है. आरबी पॉजिटिव आया, इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वो पॉजिटिव वाई डायरेक्शन में है. नहीं, ओरिजिनली अज्यूम सेंस ऑफ आरबी इज करेक्ट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस पॉजिटिव साइन. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड देयरफॉर इट इज डाउनवर्ड. फाइन. सो आरबी नाउ वी हैव फाउंड आउट. नाउ हाउ डू वी गेट पीए? सो नाउ यू कैन अप्लाई समेशन एफ वाई इक्वल टू जीरो एंड यू कैन इजिली ऑब्टेन वैल्यू ऑफ वीए. डू यू एग्री विद मी? So summation fy equal to 0 implies. Chalo. Now this 15 is downward, so therefore minus. Minus 15, minus 20, minus 35, minus 20, minus 15. Do you agree with me?
Sir, I think there is a problem from my side. I am not able to see your screen.
You are not
So I
able to
will.
see my screen.
So yes, I will just leave and log in again.
Yes, do that. So meanwhile, Kushagra, can you unmute yourself? I have sent you the request to unmute. Please accept that and unmute, Kushagra.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So therefore, now we have seen RB is 140 plus 140 pound acting downward. Now let us look at, let us apply summation Fy equal to 0. So 15 downward, so minus 15. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Minus 15, minus 20, minus 35. Minus 15, minus 20, minus 35.
Minus 7.
Minus 20, minus 15. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then you also have this minus RB. What is that minus RB? RB we have already calculated 140. So it is minus 140. Are you with me? This
yes, sir.
Plus VA. Because VA is we have shown acting upward.
Yes, sir.
This must be equal to 0. HA doesn't have any component in vertical direction. So now tell me what is the value of VA. So everything goes on the right hand side.
Sir,
so VA is 245 pounds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And it has turned out to be positive. What is the meaning of positive sign? Originally assumed sense of VA is correct. So we assumed originally VA as upward. Therefore, I'm going to call it as upward reaction. So have we solved the problem? What was being asked? Tension in cable BC. Have we found out tension in cable BC? Yes, this RB is the thing, but tension in cable BC. Are you with me? So
yes,
this
sir.
RB itself is the tension in cable BC. So this is first answer. And we have been also asked to find out reaction at A. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So have we found out horizontal as well as vertical reaction at A? Yes. Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So HA is 0 and VA is equal to plus 245, that is upward 245 pound. This is the answer to the first part. So we have in totality solved the problem. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now we are going to solve the next problem where you have a hinge support at one end and you have a roller support at other end of a beam. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So hinge support and roller support. And now I'm going to show a new type of loading. Dekho. On half length of the beam, you have something called as uniformly distributed load. And its value is given as 20 Newton per meter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And this distance up to which this uniformly varying load acts is 4 meter. And this distance is also 4 meter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this 8 meter, that is the distance between supports of the beam, is also called as span of the beam. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the span of the beam? Span of the beam is 8 meter. And on this 8 meter, the half of left half span is loaded with uniformly distributed load with intensity 20 Newton per meter. So what is the name? That name I will write down. It is called as uniformly distributed load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Uniformly distributed load. So what do we mean by that? Iska matlab ye hai, you walk 1 meter on this beam and you would have got the force of 20 Newton. Are you with me? You walk another 1 meter, you will get additional 20 Newton. So if you have walked 2 meters on the beam where this 20 Newton per meter is acting, the total force that would have been accumulated is 20 into 2, that is 40 Newton. Samajh mein aa raha hai?
Haan, sir.
So therefore, this is the intensity of loading, and it is not loading in itself. It is 20 newton per meter. So force per meter run is the intensity. What is the total load? So to get the total load, you have to multiply it by length. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And if this intensity does not vary from point to point over the span of the load, then we call such load as uniformly distributed load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This has also one more nomenclature, that this is also called as rectangular load. Kya bolenge?
Rectangular load.
Rectangular load. Why rectangular? Because if you look at the graphical representation of this load, it is a rectangle. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
It has constant value of ordinate 20 and length equal to 4 meters. So it is a rectangle of size 20 by 4. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Therefore, this is also uniformly distributed load, is also called as rectangular load. And you have been asked to find out reactions at A and B, so you need to calculate reactions at A and support B. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what do we do now? We are now going to draw free body diagram. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do I draw free body diagram of this beam? FBD of beam AB. Beam AB. So free the body from all external agencies and show what the external agencies were doing is called as free body diagram. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, free it from the earth, but there is no mention of self weight in the problem statement. So you have been implicitly asked to neglect the self weight. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So therefore, I am neglecting the self weight. Then next external agency is this support A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the type of support A? Is it a hinge support? Yes.
It's a hinge.
So what kind of reactions does it offer? It can offer two orthogonal reactions. One VA and another HA. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And look at this support. What kind of support is it?
Rolling, sir.
So what kind of reaction can it offer? It can offer only vertical force reaction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I am going to call it as RB. These are the three reactions that these supports can offer. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
None of these supports are able to offer moment reaction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So when the beam is supported only by two supports, that two which are not able to apply the moment reaction, then we call such beam as simply supported beam. Kya bolenge?
Simply supported beam.
So what is simple support? The support which cannot offer moment reaction, it offers only force reactions. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So we call this beam as simply supported beam. Why simply supported? Because both the supports are simple supports. Simple supports are the supports which do not offer moment reaction. They offer only force reaction. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, I have to show this external load as well. So, yeah, external load, maine yahan pe dikha diya. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the intensity? 20 newton per meter. Are you with me?
Yes,
this
sir.
Is 4 meter. This is 4 meter. There is another way in which I show uniformly distributed load. Kaise dikhate hai? Dekho. Aise bhi dikhaya jata hai. Are you with me? This is also the symbol for uniformly distributed load. And you will write down the intensity. So iska matlab dono ka matlab same hi hai. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So, ध्यान में रखना, प्रॉब्लम में कैसे भी दिखाया जा सकता है, आइदर दिस वे और दिस वे, रेक्टेंगुलर और दिस सिंबल. व्हाट इट मींस इज इट इज यूनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लोड. ओके?
यस सर.
नाउ ओनली फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ रिएक्शंस वी टैकल दिस यूनिफॉर्मली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लोड और फॉर दैट मैटर एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लोड इन अ पर्टिकुलर फैशन. एंड व्हाट इज दैट? We remove the entire load. ये जो rectangular pattern दिखता है ना, वो remove करते हैं and we replace it by a single force. Are you with me? एंड हाउ डू वी डू दैट? सो उसके लिए मैं आपको एक ट्रिक बताने वाला हूँ. व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू कंप्यूट द एरिया ऑफ दिस रेक्टेंगल दैट इज द टोटल लोड. आर यू विथ मी?
यस सर.
सो कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द टोटल लोड इन दिस केस? टोटल लोड करस्पॉन्डिंग टू यूडीएल ऑफकोर्स. Are you with me? This is
yes.
total load corresponding to uniformly distributed load. We write it in shorthand as UDL. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the total load? So what you have to do is you have to take the area of this rectangle. Can you find out area of this rectangle easily? Kitna hoga wo? 20
80
multiplied by 4
80.
Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the unit of 20 newton per meter?
Newton per meter.
What is the unit of 4 meter? So what is the unit of resulting quantity? Newton.
Newton.
So total load corresponding to UDL is now 80 newton. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So if I were to replace this entire UDL by a single force, what should be the magnitude of that single force? It should be 80 newton. Are you with me? And where should it act? It should act at the centroid of this rectangle. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
We have a proof for that, but that we will discuss little later. But it should act at the centroid of this rectangle. So where is the centroid? Can you tell me? At 2 meter.
Yeah, 2 meter.
Are you with me? So ab kya karna hai? Man hi man mein, you have to remove this shaded area and apply 80 newton force at this centroid. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And find out the reactions as we have done in earlier problem. Trick samajh mein aaya kya karna hai?
Haan, sir.
Whenever there is a distributed load, irrespective whether it is uniformly distributed or not, whenever there is a distributed load, you have to remove that loading. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And replace it by a single force. Kaise karna hai? Area under that distributed area of that distributed load diagram is the total load, and it acts at the centroid of the distributed load diagram. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So can I draw a revised free body diagram now? Yes. This is VA. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This is HA. This is RB. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And where is this 80 newton acting? This 80 newton, which is the equivalent load of the distributed uniformly distributed load, acts at a distance 2 meter. So this distance is 6 meter.
Yes.
Happy? This completes the free body diagram. This is A. This is B. Now, how do I find out reactions? The first thing that I'm going to do is summation fx equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
Do you agree with me? That yes, gives me HA must be equal to 0.
Yes, sir.
There is no other force. So HA must be equal to 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now I will take moments of all the forces about Z axis passing through A equal to 0. Summation of moments of all the forces about Z axis. Through A equal to 0. So does HA and VA produce any moment about Z axis passing through A? No, because their lines of actions pass through A. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
What is the moment of this 80 newton force? Tell me about A.
So
80
into 160.
80 into 2. Oh, don't tell me the number. Tell me 80 into 2. What is the sense? Clockwise or anti-clockwise?
So clockwise,
negative sign. So negative sign. Then what is the moment of this RB?
So RB into 8.
Yes, clockwise or anti-clockwise?
Anti-clockwise.
So therefore its sign is going to be positive.
Positive.
With me. This must be equal to 0. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So therefore, how much is RB?
So 20.
20 newton. As RB has turned out to be positive, what is its meaning? Originally assumed sense of RB is correct and therefore it is upward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, what do I do next? Now I apply summation Fy equal to 0. Happy?
Yes, sir.
चलो समेशन एफ वाई इक्वल टू जीरो गिव्स मी व्हाट, वी ए प्लस वी ए चलो माइनस ए टी
प्लस आर बी
प्लस
आर बी प्लस 20
यस प्लस 20 दिस मस्ट बी इक्वल टू जीरो. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ वी ए
60.
So VA turns out to be plus 60 Newton. And what is the plus sign indicate? What does the plus sign indicate? Bolo.
It is acting upwards.
No, originally assumed sense of VA is correct.
Yeah.
Therefore, it is acting upward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So have we found out all the reactions? Yes, we have found out HA, we have found out VA, and we have found out VB.
RB.
Happy?
Yes, sir.
So this was the second problem. Now quickly we will go through next two problems. It will not consume more than 5 to 10 minutes. So let us go through them. So this is problem number 14. Now just have a look at this. What kind of loading it is? This is called as trapezoidal loading. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
जैसे इसको रेक्टेंगुलर लोडिंग बोला था वैसे ट्रेपेजॉइडल लोडिंग बोला था एंड द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ लोडिंग इटसेल्फ चेंजेस. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
अनफॉर्चुनेटली द डायग्राम ड्रॉन इज नॉट करेक्ट. आई एम अफ्रेड. नो इट्स करेक्ट. 150 पाउंड्स पर फीट एंड यहाँ पे इंटेंसिटी कितना है 120 पाउंड्स पर फीट. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड व्हाट डू वी नीड टू डू? वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट रिएक्शंस एट ए एंड बी. आर यू विद मी? चलो अब रिएक्शंस एंड ए एंड बी मुझे अगर फाइंड आउट करने हैं तो आई विल हैव टू रिप्लेस दिस लोड ट्रेपेजॉइडल लोड बाय अ सिंगल फोर्स. आर यू विथ मी?
यस सर.
लेकिन ट्रेपेजॉइड का सेंट्रॉइड का फॉर्मूला हमारे पास है बट दैट इज इफ दैट इज डिफिकल्ट टू रिमेंबर कैन आई कन्वर्ट दिस ट्रेपेजॉइडल लोडिंग इन टू दी rectangular loading plus triangular loading.
Yes, sir.
So can I call this loading as rectangular or uniformly distributed load with intensity 120 pounds per feet? Are you with me? Plus,
yes, sir.
Plus. देखो यहाँ पे, this is 30 pound per feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
In दोनों का addition is going to give me the original trapezoidal load. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, can I convert each of these loads into individual point loads easily? What is the area of this rectangle? Tell me. 120 into 9. 1080, sir. So 120 into 9, right?
Yes, sir.
So it is how much? 1080. Pounds. And where does it act? It acts at the centroid. So centroid is at 4.5 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Chalo. Now, what about this? What is the area? Area is half into 9 into 30. So how much? 225.
225.
And where does it act? Pardon?
Sir, 135. Sir, 15 into 9.
15 into 9, yeah. 135 Newton. And where does it act? The centroid of this triangle lies at one third from base, one third of height from base. So it will act at 3 feet. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So how does the free body diagram look like? So quickly we will draw free body diagram. At A, you are going to have two reactions, VA and HA. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And at B, you are going to have one reaction, that is RB. And you have two point loads, one corresponding to this rectangular portion of trapezoidal load, that is 1080 lb. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
1080 lb, that acts at how much distance? That acts at 4.5 meter from 4.5 feet from either side.
Yeah.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then you have this loading, which is 135, not Newton, mind you, this has to be pounds. 135 lb.
And
it acts at distance
3 feet.
3 feet. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So now what do we do next? Same thing. Summation fx equal to 0. This is going to give me ha equal to 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then summation of moments of all the forces about z axis. I am calling this as x, this as y, and coming out of the plane of board towards you is z.
Yes.
About a through z axis passing through a equal to 0. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So kis kis ka moment aega? 135 into 3 clockwise. So minus, yes. 135 into 3. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Then 1080 into 4.5 clockwise.
Minus.
So minus. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And then RB into 9 feet, but that is anti-clockwise. So positive plus positive. RB into 9. This has to be equal to 0. So tell me how much is RB. RB will be equal to 135 into 3 plus 1080 into 45 divided by 9.
So 585
Newton upward. Why upward? Because it has turned out to be positive. So originally assumed sense of RB is correct.
Yes.
So RB is plus 585. This is the sign. Plus 585 Newton. It is not 1585. Please, if you are mistaken by this, let me remove the sign. So it is 585 Newton. And summation Fy equal to 0. Tell me, what do I get? So it is, that gives me what? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Plus VA.
Yes, plus VA.
Minus 1080. Are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Minus 135 plus 585 is equal to 0. So how much is VA? Tell me.
Sir, 630.
And it also has turned out to be positive. Therefore, okay. Originally assumed sense is correct. And therefore, yes. It is upward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have found out all the reactions VA, HA, and RB.
Yes, sir.
Good to go?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So we have ventured maybe 10 minutes, but we took some time to start. So what we will do is we will finish this problem and then we will finish its free body diagram and then we will stop.
Yes, sir.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now on this beam, this is problem number 41. Chalo. So this is triangular load. The triangular load is called as uniformly varying load. Kya kehte isko? Uniformly
varying load.
Uniformly varying load. UVL or triangular load. Are you with me? Jaise yes. Rectangular load and UDL hai, uske jaisa isko hum bolte hai UVL or triangular load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this is the type of loading. So trick is same. So there are two portions on which you have uniformly varying load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And there is one portion over which you have UDL, portion CD.
Yes, sir.
So CD portion pe rectangular load hai. If you look at, this is the rectangle.
Yes, sir.
Then on portion PC, you have triangular load. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And on portion AB as well, you have triangular load. So ab hum direct calculation karenge. I want to draw free body diagram. So how do I draw? So at B, you are going to have two reactions. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
VB and HB. Now I will intentionally not show HB because HB is going to be 0 if you take summation fx equal to 0. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
सो वो दिखाने की जरूरत नहीं है, बट लेट अस शो इट. सो दिस इज एच बी एंड व्हाट इज द रिएक्शन दैट यू हैव एट पॉइंट सी? ओनली वन रिएक्शन. आर यू विद मी? नाउ इफ यू लुक एट दिस बीम, देर इज ए ओवरहैंगिंग पोर्शन ऑन आइदर साइड. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड एज डबल ई ओवरहैंगिंग बीम. You have simple supports at B and C, and some portion of the beam overhangs on either sides. So, is beam ko hum bolenge doubly overhanging beam. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And I call this reaction as RC. These are two overhanging portions. Unke upar load ab dikhana hai. How do I show the load? So, what is the area of this triangle? First triangle, batao. Half multiplied by 480 into 3.
Yeah. So 720.
So this is equal to 720. Do you agree with me? And that yes. 720 is going to act at the centroid.
Okay.
Of this. That centroid will be 2/3 of 3 from B. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So it is going to act somewhere here. That load I am going to show as 720. And what is this distance? That distance is 2/3 of 3. Centroid, 2/3 of 3. So 2/3 of 3 is 2. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So this distance is 2 feet. Now what about this area? This is 600. So 600. Half into 600 into
8 or 9 side.
6.
So we are taking with respect to A or B.
No, area of this triangle, how much it is?
Okay. Yeah.
Half 600. Into 600 into 6. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So how much is that?
1800.
1800. So that is 1800 pound force. And where does it act? 2/3 of 6 from B. So yes, what sir. Is 2/3 of 6?
4.
So at distance 4 from here, this distance is 4. And what is the force? 1800.
Yeah.
Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is this rectangular area? Tell me. 2 into 600.
1200.
So it is 1200 pound. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And where is the centroid? It is at 1 feet from C.
Yes, sir.
So this distance, this is going to be how much? 1200.
1200.
And it is at what distance?
1 feet.
1 meter. 1 feet.
1 feet.
Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, quickly. Summation fx equal to 0 gives me what? This implies
zero.
HB is equal to 0. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, next. Summation of moments of all the forces about Z axis passing through A equal to 0. That gives me what? So what is the moment of 720? 720 into 2 anti-clockwise.
Yes, positive.
So positive. There is no moment of HB and V. Oh, we are taking at B, not B. B. So there is no moment of HB and VB. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the moment of 1800? 1800 into 4 clockwise. So minus.
Minus
1800 into 4. Happy?
Yes, sir.
What is the moment of this 1200?
1200.
So this distance is 6 plus 1, 7 feet. So 1200 into 7. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And that too clockwise.
Clockwise. Negative.
So minus 700 into
7.
Oh, 1200. I'm sorry. 1200 into 7. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the moment of RC? RC into 6.
Yes, sir.
But that is anti-clockwise. So plus RC into 6. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This has to be equal to 0. So that gives me RC equal to how much? Tell me.
Yes. So 2360 negative.
RC has turned out to be negative.
Sir, wait a second, sir. Sir, no, positive.
ठीक से करो. टू थ्री टू
थ्री जीरो
सिक्स. आई होप यू सब्ट्रैक्टेड 720 इनटू टू फ्रॉम समेशन ऑफ दिस टू, राइट?
यस सर, यस सर, यस.
सो दिस इज इन पाउंड्स एंड पॉजिटिव साइन, देयरफॉर ओरिजिनली अज्यूम सेंस ऑफ आरसी इज करेक्ट, देयरफॉर इट इज अपवर्ड. आर यू विद मी?
यस सर.
एंड देन समेशन एफ वाई इक्वल टू जीरो, दैट गिव्स मी व्हाट? दैट गिव्स मी -720 -1800 -720 -1800 -1200. आर यू विथ मी?
यस सर.
प्लस वीबी, प्लस वीबी, प्लस 2360, दैट इज आर सी इज जीरो. डू यू एग्री विथ मी?
यस सर.
एंड हाउ मच इज वीबी देन?
1360
प्लस या माइनस?
प्लस प्लस.
सो वीबी इज प्लस 1360
1360
पाउंड्स. As it is positive, therefore originally assumed sense of VB is correct, and therefore it is upward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So with this, we are going to conclude today's class. So what are the key summary points? Beam is a 1D or skeletal member which has its one dimension dominant over other two dimensions, and it is loaded perpendicular to its axis or perpendicular to its length. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And for beam, typically, if the load lies in single plane, we have three equations of equilibrium which are non-trivial, and therefore we can solve for three reactions. Are you with
me? Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will continue few more problems on beams in next class, and then we are going to wind up this equilibrium chapter, and we are going to start with dynamics, first yes. chapter of dynamics. So with
sir,
this, we can go ahead.
So sorry, Mr. Yu, sir. Yesterday we left few problems on wire of sir. Can you solve it also?
No. That is the loss. We are not going to solve.
Please, sir. So we are not able to find out who did that. So
yeah, that's okay. But that is the loss. Let it be there. So what you can do is, if you want, you can solve those problems on your own and send it to me. I will definitely check those problems. That much I can do.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So in from next class, we are going to start with dynamics. Very important. Don't miss next class. It is the starting of dynamics. Yes. And we will be dealing with rectilinear, uniform, non-uniformly accelerated motions and curvilinear motions. So today, let us stop here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Write down your roll number and name in chat box, and then you can leave the meeting. If anyone has any doubt, you can raise your hand. I will unmute you.